Let's read John 11.
Ari ebukenge John 11.
From verse 15.
Ritame malawo verse 15.
John 11.
John 11.
The book of John.
Buka buguni ya John.
From verse 15.
Ritame ka verse 15.
Maybe we can start from 12.
Tangwaringa tumaka 12.
The disciples answered, "Lord, if he has asleep, he has fallen asleep, he will recover." However, Jesus had spoken of his death, but they thought that he was referring to natural asleep.
So then
Jesus told them plainly, "Lazarus is dead. And for your sake, I'm glad that I was not there so that you may believe. But let us go to him."
Fela ke tabaka bakala lena ge ke be ke segona gore ke tle ke o tleletle dumele jwale gona ari engwe yena.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I was reading this, I found a great revelation.
Na ke bala taba cheke ka thola kutulo e kgolo.
And a great lesson to us all today.
Le thuto e kgolo gore ena le gona.
By the time when Jesus was told about Lazarus is sick,
kana kwa Jesu ba mmotsa gore Lazarus wa lwala,
the disciple heard that he was sick.
Barutiwa ba ikwile le bona taba ya gore Lazarus wa bajwa.
But Jesus stayed more days.
Mara Jesu mo dula matatsi a mangwe gape.
Until he got a message from above.
O fitela o fita mulae tsa jono wa hore Lazarus a saliwe o khwile.
If you can hear, these were two messages. The first message
were
coming by the messengers from the house of Lazarus. But Jesus waited for the message from above. When he waited, he knew what he is supposed to go and do. If you can read, you realize that this words that Jesus spoke on verse 15.
Manja Jesu abuletseng mola go verse 15.
He says, "For your sake I'm glad."
Fela ke thaba ka baka la lena.
That when he died I was not there.
Ore ha tlhoko fela ishwane ke seteng.
So that you may believe.
Ore lena le tsebe go dumela.
What Jesus was saying.
Taba ye Jesu na ibolela.
He was saying, "I understand you have seen some things in my life.
Ke a bona ke a kwishisha re le bone tshedingwe mo bophelong wa ka.
Those things that you have seen
tele di bone
have brought doubt.
Dikaba di tsitse pila ele go lena.
But this one
mara ye yona
will make you to trust more.
E tlo dira gore le tshepe go fitisha.
Can you just tell your neighbor, trust more?
A ke le botsa motho leng ga o se tshepa go fitisha.
Can you trust him more?
O ka mo tshepaga go fitisha na.
Here Jesus never just spoke this way.
Mo Jesu a zanga no bulela fela mantshia.
There were many people who were speaking when he does miracles.
Na ona le batho ba ne ba bulela ga ntsha dia metlholo.
Sometimes when he speak things no one understood him.
Na go tshedingwa a bulela ditaba batho ba thaloganya ba kwishishi.
But the opportune time came.
Mara taba na ko ya munyeta ya fita.
Of making even the ones he's having to believe in him. He said, "On this one, when you reach there, you will realize that this man is dead. And this time, you people need to trust me." Listen to this. I found in our Christian life, there are times when God does something. But it doesn't take us to where we trust him. But today God wants to do something that will make you to trust him more.
So
can you tell
about
today the Lord will do something so that you trust him more. How many of you are ready to trust him? Put your hands down. A trust is established between where you are and the fulfillment of the promise. Where you are to the fulfillment of your promise. How you act towards the destiny of the promise. It shows if you trust or not. Because trust is more like confidence.
Or
dependence. I don't know if you're hearing me. Whatever you are going through, you are being checked before the promise is fulfilled. So where you are towards the destiny of the promise, you'll be checked if you trust more. There is something that wants to happen today that will bring and establish your trust. So that what God wants to do with your life, you'll be able to hold yourself until you receive it. One of our problems today is a lack of trust because of the challenges we went through, because of the results that we're expecting and we receive few. But God here, he wants us to trust him. Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
That's what I say, my friend. Trust him more. Listen to this. If you remember Daniel 3, we know this verse of 16 to 18, we could see these guys that they trust the Lord and they trusted him more. The Bible says when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego see everybody bowing, they forget the position they were given. They forget the salary they were offered. They reach a level of saying, we can rather lose our lives because we know the one we are serving. Trusting tells you that you know the one you are serving. There are some people who are here today who are facing what Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego face, but they are not wavering. They know who they are saving. I love the statement that they said. If you can see, the Bible didn't say it was
Shadrach
or Meshach. It says they all answered. They had confidence even when they are seeing fire. They had confidence even if they can lose whatever they have. They say, okay, we have got nothing to answer you. If the one we are saving, if the one we are trusting is not going to save us from this, it's better we perish. We need Christians who are not looking at themselves by what they are facing. They can still face the furnace and say, you are taking me to the furnace. I understand what the furnace will do to me, but I trust someone who can save me from the furnace. Today, we have got Christians who are listening to me. I'm here to say trust more because you are about to overcome that furnace. Trust more from where you are to what you are encountering. What you are facing is nothing compared to what God wants to do with you. Sometimes God will allow you to face some things I can tell you this. If you carry on trusting, you will carry on having results that will glorify God. Can I tell you this? There are many challenges that you people must face. Christians are determined by the challenges they face, not by the blessing they receive. So the moment when you face a challenge, where you are, remember the promise. Remember what the Lord said. His promises are yes. And in Christ, amen. He will never leave you or forsake you. What you need to do, trust more. Trust more. Because whatever you are facing is there to affect your trust, so that you lose your faith. Trust more, you will see the result. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I can see Christians who are being challenged by diseases, by stumbling block and shame, by spirit of limitation and all. But I'm here to declare to you that from now on, God will give you a strength. The Bible says, those who trust in the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They will never get tired. They will run to their destiny. I say, trust more, because you are closer to where you are going. I don't know if you are hearing me. When things go tough, understand that you are closer to the opening gate. Don't retire where you are. Just refire, because God is expecting you to enter there. There are some people who are here, but I have to tell you that today the opening door is waiting for you. Just trust God. Trust more and carry on running, because where you are going, you will even forget what you have been facing. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I declare opening door. I declare opening gate. But trust more, because God is up to something. There is something that is in store for you. There's a blessing that you have been waiting for. And devil wants you to turn back from where you're going. But I'm here to tell you, don't turn back. Carry on running, because where you're going, you are being expected to receive what you are supposed to receive. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Trust more. Trust more. Listen to this. I found that in my experiences. Those who know me, any challenge come with an offer. Any challenge come with a blessing. If you want to see that God wants to honor you, there's a challenge. Don't look at the challenge. Look at the blessing. Because there is someone who can offer better than the challenge they are giving you. And I'm here to tell you that you need to trust more. The one who allowed the challenge to come to your life. Don't look at the challenge. Look at the one who wants to offer you a blessing. If you believe, say amen. I see some people here today. They are facing what they are facing. But there's a new level that God is expecting. Can I tell you this? I say, trust more. Trust more. Tell your neighbor, trust more. Why you need to trust? If you open the book, if you go to Proverbs, Proverbs 28 to 25. The Bible says, trusting will change your appearance. You are bound to be fed when you trust. I found that when you worry, you become thin.
Hey, whatever I will be like, I will order.
But when you trust, you become fat because you relax. What God wants you to do,
He wants
you to relax. If you
read
Jeremiah 7:8, you will see what trust does. It brings a prophet.
It is so holy.
There's a prophet. There is a prophet that God wants you to have.
Jeremiah 7:8.
You have to be profitable when you trust. Listen, worries can't bring anything. Even Jesus said, you can't add anything in your hair because of what you are facing when you are worrying about it. But when you trust, it's like you understand what God wants to do with your life. Can I tell you this? There is a situation that you are facing, but I see a prophet coming to you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Touch someone, say, my friend, be profitable by trusting. When you trust, it's like you are losing friends. It's like you are losing all. I will tell you this. Most of the time, when we speak, we are trying to protect our ego. When we speak, we are trying to maintain our level. But sometimes we need to refrain from talking. We need to refrain if we know the one we trust. Because the reason why the disciples began to worry in the boat and say, Jesus, don't you care? We are perishing. Whereas Jesus was asleep, whereas Jesus was quiet, the quietness of Jesus was to say, trust me, I'm quiet because there is no harm. This is the time that Christians must reach a level when you pray and there is no answer. Hey, you don't need to pray again. Trust him. When he's quiet, he's organizing an answer. I don't know if you are hearing me. Listen to this. We Christians, we must reach a level where we trust him more than praying the more. Because many prayers we are doing is because we lack trust and we don't depend on him. We need Christians who are saying, I know by my trust unto the Lord I will be profitable. This year, I want to tell you, those who think there is nothing that will come upon your life, I'm here to tell you, you are about to be profitable. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Can you tell your neighbor, I'm about to be profitable? Listen, when you see the Master Jesus not speaking anything about what you are facing, know that it's working for the benefit. If you see that there's no answer, you have prayed about your situation and there's nothing. No. Rise up and begin to praise him. Rise up and forget about telling him about one thing. Because he can see before you tell him. He can see before you pray. What you need to do is to trust him. Listen to this. There are Christians like David who say, I don't care. Though I walk in the valley of shadow of death, I fear nothing. Why? Because they understand that there is no death that can separate him with their love. We need Christians who are saying, they cannot be shaken by what they are facing. I'm here to prophesy you that trust today, that trusting more is about to bring the result and the prophet that has never been seen. And if you believe, shout hallelujah. We need to be Christians this year. Can I tell you this? It's only this week. I'll tell you this thing so that you understand my messages. Because God was telling me, whatever you are facing, it's a lesson to many. When I lift you up, everybody will know. Listen, don't ever think I'm worrying about what I'm facing. Already I know in the spirit the Lord is taking me. You need to also to look at your life, because there is a place where God has designed you for. Listen, I'm teaching you what God told me.
That,
hey, don't look on your enemies. Don't look, unto me and tell my people, don't look at the enemies. They will try to attract you. They will try to do whatever. But trust me, because where I'm taking you, they can't reach there. Listen, the reason why you've got a problem which is better than them is because of the offer from the Lord which is bigger than them. The reason why they won't understand you is because God is raising you in front of them. Can I tell you this? Just trust more. Trust more. God might have done small, but there's a bigger that is coming. There might be a small car, but there's a bigger car that is coming. Trust more. Stop relaxing on what you have received. There is more in store for you. There is more that God wants to bring to you. I prophesy someone who's listening to me. I say, hey, don't look down. Look up. Arise and shine. Your time has come. This is your season of taking over. This is your season. Don't lose trust. You are closer than before. I say you are closer than before. You are closer than before. I say you are closer than before. When Job was facing points all over the body, his friends accuse him. But he said he doesn't want to see, because he knew the one he trusts. Can I tell you this? Every bad thing can still happen to good people. But listen, it happened for a reason. Whatever you are facing is for a reason. If you trust more, the Lord will honor you. Can I prophesy you? I see this week. I'm just seeing this week. I see you meeting your enemy when he's going down and you are going up. I say you are going up. I say you are going up. I prophesy you. I say what you've been waiting for is coming to you. You are becoming profitable. I say you are becoming profitable. If you believe, shout hallelujah. In Psalm 56,
verse 4,
trusting God takes fear away. Trusting God, it just takes fear away. If you want to see that fear, it's a spirit. Trust God. When any other people were saying there's no way, you carry on trusting without fear, you will see yourself there. There's something that will never come until we trust him, until fear goes. Not long I was seeing that I end up telling Christians that some fasting prayers that we normally do is because of fear. Can I tell you this? There are some things that I normally do. I just trust him. I trust him. I just trust him. I know he will take me there. Because his promises are real. He cannot lie. He will take you there. I want you not to have fear. I want you not to have fear. Just trust him. And you see the fear leaving you. Fear of a debt will leave you. Fear of opposition will leave you. You'll be here like now. Nothing is happening. Can I tell you this? You are about to dominate in front of your enemies. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Listen. The reason why you are failing in front of your enemy is because you fear them. Trust God. They will be small. Remember what happened when Joshua and other spies, when they spied
Jericho,
remember what happened? Remember what happened? When they saw children of
Anak,
they forget God. They forget the promise of God. They began to concentrate on what will happen to them. And the Bible says, Joshua and Caleb say, let us go at once. We need Christians today who can say, I can see where God has destined me for. Let me go at once. Let me go at once to my
promotion.
Let me go at once and buy that car. Let me go at once and take what belongs to me. Joshua and Caleb had faith. They have got no fear. They knew what the Lord has promised. There is something that the Lord has promised. I want to tell you, in the midst of storm, you don't need to have fear. Trust him. He's taking you there. I say he's taking you there. I say he's taking you there. I see someone here who have got afraid, fear of future. Fear of future. I want to tell that person that today the Lord is taking you there. Trust more. He's taking you there. Tomorrow will pass. On Tuesday, you are a manager. Tomorrow will pass. He's taking you there. On Tuesday, you are a millionaire. I say he's taking you there. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Can I tell you this? Whatever you are facing, just look unto him. Just look unto him. Because I'm hearing that this week is a week of defeating our enemies. You have been looking unto your enemy. They were wasting their time. And they were wasting your time. Take off your eyes and take your eyes to him, the author and the finisher of your faith. You will make sure you succeed. Can I prophesy you? This week, as you are trusting him more, I see you reaching your destiny. I see you reaching your destiny. I see you reaching your destiny. I'm here to tell you, trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. You're about to have a testimony. Trust him more. When you trust, it won't be easy. But the Lord is on your side. He will never leave you or forsake you. He's aware of what you are facing. Trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. Listen, I'm here to tell you. Trust him more. Can you tell three people? Trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. Trust him more. Because where you're going, you're closer than before. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Those who trust in the Lord, in 1 Timothy 6, verse 20, they will avoid things that make them to sin. It means when you are still waiting and you are here, before you and your destiny, what will happen? There will be things in front of you. I don't know if you are hearing me. And those things are there to trap you. I found the best one. The first one is lack. Most of the time, the reason why we look at ourselves and we cry is because of lack. When we lack somewhere,
we
don't feel comfortable.
That's where
even our prayers,
we
end up directing them
there.
And the second one is
when
we're talking about fear.
And the
third one is the issue of being lonely. Because most of the time we need a company. We need people who can speak to us or favor us. But the more when people go away from you, God is teaching you trust. When you are alone in what you are facing,
He
is telling you, trust me. Trust me alone. There are some times when family goes away, friends go away, and you are left alone in what you believe in. Trust. You'll be surprised very soon. They'll come to you one by one. I don't know if you're hearing me. So what you need to do, what you need to understand, there are things on your road. Many things that can trap you. And those things, they rise up so that you die there. But I'm here to tell you that today God will never allow you to be trapped where you are. He will take you there. I say He will take you there. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me prophesy someone. Can I prophesy someone? From here to where you are going, you are left with only one day. I say you are left with only one day. Within this day, 24 hours. I'm prophesying you at the same time, declaring to you that what you have been waiting for 3 years is waiting for you. You have been left with only one day. One day. I say one day. If you are watching, I say one day. From now to 24 hours, I see what you are waiting for coming to you. I see what you have been waiting for coming to you. I see people searching for you. And they are coming to give you that car. They are coming to give you that job. They are coming to give you that house. They are coming to you. I said they are coming to you. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Can you shake somebody? I say, my friend, you have been waiting for only this one day. Listen, I told you last time that even your enemies, they won't even understand what is happening to you. They will just say, Arezi. It is starting this week. This is the week. You will hear your enemies say, Arezi.
Arezi.
They will say, Arezi. Because they will say, we don't understand why you are driving this car. Because they heard about your salary. But they will be shocked about what God wants to do in your life. I see you possessing your possession. I see you taking over. This is the week. This is the week. I say take over. I say take over. I say take over.
Shetaulo.
There are some people that are about to receive new things altogether. Can I tell you why? Because you have been waiting and you were trusting. And now I say to you, hey, within 24 hours, trust more. Trust more. I see your job. I see your healing. I see success. I see prosperity. Receive it. Receive it. Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive it.
Receive it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
Receive
it.
when you are receiving,
how do you
I saw your enemy falling in front of you. As they falling, they are about to faint. Those who think you won't go far, I pronounce this when I'm declaring. Let them fall when you are rising. Let them fall when you are rising. Let them fall when you are rising. It is your time to take over. It is your time to move forward. It is your time. Trust him more. Within 24 hours, within 24 hours, you are about to smile. Going to the bank, you are about to smile. You are about to smile because of the promotion. You are about to smile. It is your season. It is your time. Take what belongs to you. Take what you are here for. Take your money. Take your job. I don't know what you are taking. But take something. Trust him more. You are left with 24 hours. You are left with 24 hours. I see you taking. I see you taking your car. I see you taking your house. I see you moving. It is your season. It is your season. It is your season. Your life is better if you believe. Shout hallelujah.